Hey guys, welcome to the Blue Mug Chat. Welcome to the Blue Mug Chat. I wish you all a very happy Diwali. Hope you have a wonderful, healthy and safe Diwali with your loved ones. And let's be a little conscientious towards the Mother Nature as well. And let's not try and burn crackers, because the AQI, especially in Delhi and Gurgaon, has already reached like 200 to 300 and it's not even breathable. So let's be a little sensitive towards the environment as well. Today's topic of conversation, I'm pretty sure it will hopefully raise your spirit, because I know it's the need of the hour, because it's all about music. I, for one, I am extremely passionate about music. I start my day with the chants and I end my day with something soothing, and it just makes my day. I read something really, really beautiful this morning, which is very relevant to what we are talking today. So I thought I'm going to share that with you. It's a thought from Leonard Bernstein, and he says there will be a reply to violence to make music more intensely, more beautifully, more devotedly than ever before. And I just thought it is so relevant to the world that we live in. I think music has the vastness to go beyond boundaries, to make friendships, to make connections. When you hear a good music, do you ever think who the composer is, what the caste is, what the creed is? Irrespective of whether it's a Carnatic music or a Hindustani classical or Sufi or a jazz, rock or pop, music has the power to go beyond religion, to go beyond caste, creed, race and color. And, binds us all together in one thread, which is humanity, which is so needed in the world that we live in. The melody that music creates can stir our soul. The harmony it creates actually has the power to bring about the feelings that we never thought actually existed within us. The rhythm it has, gives us that dancing in even in our sleep. So music has that power. The music has the capacity. It's the language of the soul, and it's a universal language that actually binds us all together. And today we have just the right person with us, Ramya Vashisht, who's also known as Mehsul Kokila, who's going to be with us shortly. And her journey into this this particular arena and this particular art is so vast that we'll try and travel this journey with her today. So let me bring her in, let me introduce her to all of you, and let's bring this festivity to the festival of Diwali, which is actually very challenging in the times that we are. So let me bring in Ramya and let's get on with the show. Hi Ramya, welcome to the Blue Mug Chat. So happy
thank you
to have you. It's a perfect time actually, to have something so powerful as music in these challenging times, because we just don't know what the right thing to do is now. Whether to be festive about it, not festive about it. Whether to celebrate, not celebrate, because there are still people there, who are still actually suffering, and our wishes to all of you who are undergoing, this pandemic, or your family member is going through it.
Our prayers.
So let me introduce Ramya, and then we can move ahead. Ramya is an accomplished singer, composer, lyricist, actor, anchor, and a creative director. To put it in a nutshell, Ramya Vashisht is a complete artist whose creative extension has no boundaries. Secured 100% in Carnatic classical music, is trained under Vidwan Belakavadi Srinivas Iyengar, Asthana Vidwan of Mysore Samsthana, later trained in Hindustani classical music under Pandit Vinayak Torvi, is also trained in semi-classical and contemporary under Vidwan Raju Anathaswamy. Fluency in most of the Indian languages. She is a trilingual writer in Hindustani, English, and Kannada. Shodashi, 16 Moods of Moon, and other poems in English is all set to release. Chakra Teertha, a collection of 108 Chaupadi in Kannada, is also on its way along with other poems. She's acted in some of the best TV serials in Kannada and in theatre. She was one of the jury of the folk stars of India, Mati Ke Lal, on DD Kisan, along with Sri Anu Kapoor and Srimati Ila Arun in their semi-finals and final rounds. She was also in the jury of Filmfare Kannada 2019. Welcome to the Blue Mug Chat, Ramya.
Same here, Sonal. This is such a wonderful chat show. I have been following you. And thank you so much for having me on this beautiful occasion of Deepavali. So yes, first of all, I would like to wish all your viewers and you, of course, a very, very happy Deepavali. May this Deepavali bring in new light into all our lives, which is so much in need, you know, at this time.
Yeah. I love the diyas that you're putting. It's
Oh, yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, these diyas, I mean, my house will always be full of diyas. Any corner, you'll find one or the other diya, you know, being lit. But today for this show especially, it is Jitendra Singh sir who said specially that I want to see your diyas on screen. So I said, okay, fine, let me bring them on screen. So yeah, this is...
You know, Rabia, you have been trained in Hindustani classical, you have been trained in Carnatic, and then your journey took you to Sufi music as well. So could you share that journey with us?
As in your introduction, you were saying that, you know, music is universal.
Yeah.
So there is nothing that can actually, stop music from entertaining anybody in the world. Anybody who listens to good music will get that adrenaline, you know, rush into their minds, and they will start, according to the mood of the music, they'll start, behaving or responding. So if it is Carnatic, if it is Hindustani, or if it is Sufi, I think it's mostly those swaras. You know, there are only Sapta Swaras. They say that Saat Suron Ka Ek Mala Jo Banti Hai, wohi music kehlati hai. So that is Sangeet. Whether it is in Carnatic, whether it is in Sufi, whether it is Hindustani, whether it is Western. So anywhere you go, it is only the khel, the play of seven, notes. And it's up to the musician how they try to pirona kehte hai, the way they start, bringing it in one string, putting it in a string. So I think each one has a different genre in its own way, but each one has that much of similarity also, because they are all made of same seven notes. So the journey has been quite exciting, but at the same time, the journey has not been very deviating. It has been, you know, in the same path. So it has been a nice journey, but what excited me about Sufi was that the lyrics that in Sufi or in any other lyric-oriented music that we get to, you know, hear. So what happens is, of course, the music or the sur will have its own effect on us, but the lyrics will kind of double it up. And it will exactly make you feel as if the singer is singing what's going on inside you, you know.
Yeah.
So that's the beauty of either Sufi.
Yeah,
that's the beauty of Sufi or Ghazal or a Geet, you know, because there you find the connect with the song because of the lyrics. And I've always found that music independently is very nice, but when music coupled with lyrics is like the marriage of music and lyrics, you know, it is the best form of music that we get to hear. That's what I feel always.
Yeah. You know, you said it very beautifully. जो हम सात सुरों को जो पेड़ के जो बनाते हैं ना वो म्यूजिक है उसका जो उतार उसका जो permutation combination है. You know, it's a miracle that from that सात सुर how much comes out, you know, in different forms. It's just absolutely beautiful. So I do know a little bit. So I've also been trained in Hindustani classical. I did my 5 years of training, so I know a little bit about Hindustani classical. So I know that, for both Carnatic and Hindustani, the ancestry is the same. but somewhere they actually branch out to different directions, right? I would be very keen to know how it branches out, where it branches out actually, and how does that work?
I feel when we dig into the history of these classical forms, it is very, it's very controversial. It's very exciting. You know, it is very exciting because you get to understand that they are from the same land, you know. But it's very controversial because, again, who has come first? It's like the egg and the chick. You can't really say that whether it is Carnatic, whether it's Hindustani. But keeping the traditional aspects that one form has retained, like, they all say that, it was Samved which gave rise to music in India or these classical forms. Agar Samved ne kiya hai usko, so Samved, the way we sing Samved is mostly Hindustani. But the Shastra that we follow in both the forms is mostly Carnatic.
Acha, acha, okay.
Okay, so now what would you conclude here? So I feel both are like two eyes. You can't say that I'm going to watch only from one eye and I am not going to see from the other. That is what led me to learn both also, because I feel that ek shaili, ek presentation. Now you want to present dosa, now you want to present pizza. You know, but what actually goes into each is different. But the one who likes it, the making, everything will have its own process. You know, so like that, even in Carnatic, it's very deep, it's very meditative, and it is highly, Shastra-oriented. Okay? When it comes to Hindustani, in Carnatic, it is mostly lyric-oriented. We have a Kriti, we have a Vagyakara who writes the Kriti and composes himself. So he is called Vagyakara. But in Hindustani, it is mostly that Mukhda and Antra is just chosen or written for the sake of building the raga.
For the raga, correct.
Yeah, because you want to establish the bhav of the raga. The rag has to really, you know, spread across. And it should keep lingering everywhere. For which you start using the lyrics. So lyrics is not really important in Hindustani. So keeping these two in mind, yes, it is like, I keep telling whenever I do Harikatha, I keep telling my friends that it is one Veda Vyasa which gave rise to all the three darshanas. That is Advaita, Dvaita and Vishishtadvaita. Whether for Shankaracharya, whether for Ramanujacharya or whether for Madhvacharya, it was only one guru. So likewise, it is one land, that is one Veda you can call it as, which gave rise to these two forms. But they are similar, they are different in their own ways.
Yeah.
It's like a dizygotic twins, you know.
Right.
Yeah, it is like that.
Would you be able to sing both and tell us this is Hindustani classical and this is Carnatiki? Like, would that be a possibility? I think that way we will really...
I'll try to. See, yeah. I'll just tell, my gurus were like very much against me trying to learn both, because they believe that one lifetime is not enough for one form. Then how can you just keep dabbling with both? I mean, it's like traveling in two boats and you never know where the destination is. But I feel that...
So I think you're good to learn both.
Yeah, but what I felt was it is just one life. Who knows when next what life is? So when else will you come back to learn this again? So whatever little I could gather, I have tried to gather. In that, there's one rag which is called Durga.
Durga.
Okay. Durga rag in Hindustani. And we have the same Arohan and Avrohan, that ascendant and the descendant, of the same in Carnatic called Shuddha Saveri.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So there is a Kriti of Tyagaraja in Shuddha Saveri. And there is a cheese, Chota Khyal in Hindustani, of Durga. I'll try to present both. No, you'll know the difference. Especially those who can understand Telugu will understand the value of the lyrics and will understand how the composition has come about, you know, how Tyagaraja has written. And those who want to really enjoy the rag, the latmar attitude of Durga, you know, they will enjoy that. Okay. I'll just try to present there. Let me see how it is received.
Kalaharan mel raha Sita Ram 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 kalaharan mel raha
See, in Carnatic, we should not stop the Kriti without singing the Ankita or the pen name that has been used in composition. So I will go to the Charanam.
Dina dina monu tirigi tirigi dikuleka sharanu chochi dina dina monu tirigi tirigi dikuleka sharanu chochi tanu dhanamu nide Tanu dhanamu nideyennu chotyagarajavinu tarama Tanu dhanamu nideyennu chotyagarajavinu tarama Kalaharanamelara hare Sita Rama Kalaharana Mel raha re hare.
So this is Carnatic.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
But Tantra, what? Oh my God, it's absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, Carnatic is very meditative. Yes. So now I would like to sing one Taan in Hindustani. So you will know how Durga is viewed or perceived in Hindustani.
Dhimna dhani tanadirdum dhimna dhani tanadirdum dhimna dhani tanadirdum dhari dhari tanadirdum dhari dhari tanadirdum dhirdana dani tanadhiranani dhimna dhani tanadirdum dhimna dhani tanadirdum dhimna dhiyana dhimna dhani dhimna dhiyana dhimna
See, it's mostly how you perceive the raga, and it is very dangerous, you know, it is very dangerous to sing the same, both at the same time, because what happens is both of them will have its own sancharas, its own you know, perceptions, like how a Carnatic singer would perceive or will have a perspective of Durga or Shuddha Saveri, as I told you, and how a Hindustani singer will have a perspective and how it is being taught also. So it is very, it is like, I think you can switch to Western to an extent when you are singing Indian poems, but singing two different Indian poems is not easy. There were very few.
No.
What happens is many a times when you have Saath, you know, all these accompanying artists and all, you'll get some time to breathe. When it is you are performing alone, there is absolutely no breathing time. But coming to this, there were very few who were performing both. They were called Ubhaya Gana Visharadas. So both the forms, they were, you know, excellent, and they were Vidwans of both, Vidushis of both. One is Vidushi Shamalaji Bhavema. She was excellent. She used to sing both flawlessly, both authentically, and that's more important, I feel, you know. To be authentic, when you present a classical form, it's very important to be authentic than being anything. Because the Shastras needs to speak through your voice and your singing. Yeah.
It was just divine. And to be able to present it impromptu like that with just the Tanpura.
I was not really prepared. Anyway.
Now, I would also like to know a little bit about the Sufi music. I know it's a devotional music which was originated by the Sufi poets like Rumi, Amir Khusro, Bulle Shah. Could you tell us a little bit more about, what is the essence of Sufi music?
See, the best thing about Sufism is not, one more thing I want to tell my audience is that Sufism is not new to India.
Yeah.
Okay. The Bhakti movement, what we had, is all about surrenderance. If we think of it as bhakti, then a step above of bhakti is Sufi, wherein you start seeing your God, the one whom you say as Almighty, as your lover. So in Sufi, that's what Meera did, that's what Andal did, that's what Lalleshwari in Kashmir did. You know, that's what Akka Mahadevi from Karnataka did. They all saw the Almighty as their lover forever, the eternity lover of their lives. So, Sufism is just that. But again, you'll also see somebody like Tukaram, somebody like Purandaradasa, all of these great saints calling him as their best consort. Or they considering themselves to be his best consort. His is God again. So here the play of Prakriti and Purusha is what is beautifully told in Sufi as well. In Sufi, what happens is everybody who wants to be a Sufi saint, hum unko Sufi sant jo bolte hain, they consider themselves to be feminine. Whether they are male or female, they are feminine in gender. And it is only one masculine for the whole universe, and that is Almighty. That's what is the beauty of Sufi is what I could discover. And as you said, yes, somebody like Khusro, Bulle Shah, they have given such wonderful literary, treasure to this. It is amazing. And those who can, again, this is the language-based music. Literature-based music. So in this, one has to really understand the bhav, the feel of the lyrics. And that's when you can enjoy the song. That's the beauty of Sufi. Yeah.
Can you honor us with
a few? Oh, yeah, sure. I would love. Sufi is like...
I'm very speaking now.
Go ahead,
please.
Yeah, but one thing with me is I keep daring in life to do everything, like pata nahi ki usko accept kiya jayega, saraha jayega, whatever, but I keep just trying my hands in whatever I feel I can connect with, So in that way, Sufi is a very good platform or very good medium, I felt, to connect with my Almighty. So I have just penned about 30 to 50 Sufi numbers in Hindustani.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so myself, yes.
You have composed them?
I've composed them, yes.
Oh, wow. So can we hear composition?
Yeah, surely. I have written and composed this, which I'll be singing now. So this was my 15th or 20th, composition. But this is my most favorite one. So I will sing this.
Can I just request you to move in the center of the screen? You're a little on the right. Just a center would be better. Perfect. Perfect. Now we can see. Yeah. Perfect.
Great.
Please go
okay.
ahead.
I need Tanpura. तेरे बिन मोहे नहीं लागे नैनन खुले सारी रतिया जागे नैनन खुले सारी रतिया जागे ओ झूठे जग में तेरी जोगन तुझको ही ढूंढे एक बंजारन हो झूठे जग में तेरी जोगन तुझको ही ढूंढे एक बंजारन नाम तेरी मीरा नाम तेरी हीरा पर मेरे प्यार का तू है सवेरा तू ही मेरा राम तू ही मेरा रांझना तू ही मेरा श्याम तू ही मेरा सांझना ओढ़ के कफन दुनिया से लड़ गई कभी न हारी मेरा अग्नि परीक्षा दे गई सीता रह गया राम संदेह कमारा ओढ़ के कफन दुनिया से लड़ गई कभी न हारी मीरा अग्नि परीक्षा दे गई सीता रह गया राम संदेह कमारा नाम तेरी सीता नाम तेरी मीरा पर मेरे प्यार का तुझ में है बसेरा तू ही मेरा राम तू ही मेरा रांझना तू ही मेरा श्याम तू ही मेरा सांझना हजारों गोपियों के बीच में चांद है राधा ना एक तारा जग में जवा और भी थे पर जान लुटा दी रांझे पे घेरा नामे तेरी राधा नामे तेरी हीरा पर मेरे प्यार का तू है सवेरा तू ही मेरा राम तू ही मेरा रांझना तू ही मेरा श्याम तू ही मेरा सांझना
Divine, absolutely divine. I feel like you are standing ovation, but I'll go off the camera if I do that. But so amazing, actually. It's just absolutely beautiful. And you are right, you know, Sufism has that mysticity about, you know, it's all about love to the divine. So
yes,
it actually goes into the soul of, you know, it actually shifts the core when you hear Sufi music playing. There's something about Sufism.
Yes.
For that matter, like you said, you know, the lyrics actually play a very, very blissful role in terms of music.
Yes, and many a times what happens, you remember that song because of the lyrics. It's not just that the tune or something. You know, the lyrics makes you remember that song, because that lyrics will connect with you, whatever you would have gone through then while listening, or you would have gone through something else in life and you would listen to this song, you know,
correct,
that would have soothed you, something like that. Yes.
Absolutely. I'm pretty sure the viewers don't want you to stop. I'm getting some messages here. They say,
oh, that's nice. That's so sweet. Thank you.
Actually, I'm going to read them all towards the end of the show. They are, I think, hi, Shalini. Yeah, I have so many of my friends joining in, and I'm pretty sure they're all enjoying your beautiful, soulful voice. And I know, Ramya,
thank you.
You also do poetry and in different languages, and you actually you have different names for your different genres, right? You do
yeah.
poetry in Urdu, in English, and Kannada, if I'm not wrong. So how do you manage to you know, to be in these different shoes, and what made you go to that to that art form actually?
See, I feel everybody is blessed with one energy, and that one energy starts getting manifested in various ways or various forms. I feel if one is an artist, they can do varied things connected to art.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. And I feel that is what is going to bring the completeness in them as an artist. So I feel writing lyrics is not different from singing, and it's not different from composing. It's not different from, you know, acting, because again, you're emoting. It's not different from like, you know, all these things. I feel every art form is connected. And if one can really have the vision of connecting it, I think everything becomes easy for that person, that artist, you know, to start experimenting or trying new things in that. So when it came to writing, I only understood that many a times there will be so many emotions in you which you really don't know how to tell it out. And how much ever you try to sing it in the form of rag or whatever, it would really not get that shape that you want to give it, you know. And I feel it's also about languages. I have understood one thing, that it is just the comprehension. The comprehension ability in one will help them learn many languages. Similarities, like in Kannada, actually, thanks to Sanskrita, because I learned Sanskrita, I can really, you know, relate to so many things in different languages, especially Indic languages. So that's how it all started. And yeah, as you said, I have very, because I started writing early, I was little, I can call it kiddish, but I started giving different pen names, like all my Hindustani Urdu ghazals and Geet, I call.
Could you tell us your pen name? Different.
Yeah.
Very beautiful, I just remember.
yeah, but for my Urdu and Hindustani ghazals, I call myself as Salma Taj. And yeah, Salma. But Salma, again, I'll tell you why I chose that name. Because once I had gone to my friend's house who had a Urdu dictionary, and we were just trying to know meaning of so many things. Then I said, just see what is the meaning of Salma. And when she opened that page, I was actually kind of moved, because it said that the silver karigari on a silk sari or a piece of cloth. That's Salma. So I was thinking how intricate one has to, to know that skill or to be that. Uh-huh. I was like, oh yeah, that's great. So I thought, okay, let me call myself Salma. And and in Kannada, but while writing, I use this pen name as Vibhuti. Because my, Vibhuti, what we keep, the ash. The ash is. Yeah. So this ash is nothing but, whenever I go to Kashi, and the first visit I made through Jitendra Singh sir only, thanks to him. But, when I went to Kashi, what I learned or understood was life is nothing but ash. But the sheer practice of keeping it on our matha, on our forehead, and going about life, is like to say that this is what it is going to be. Why do you even fight so much for everything? I mean, it's okay, let go, or make peace, be calm. So I said, why not Vibhuti for Kannada? And of course, English, it just became like my initials, RV, and I just went about writing. That's it.
Wow. See, it's one thing, like you said it, right? You said it with a lot of simplicity, that once you have that expression, you are able to express it in all different art forms. But you know what? You have to have that capacity and the ability to express it in so many art forms like you do. You have your music, of your poetry, then I know you're also an actor, right? And you are a conceptualizer, you are an anchor. You do a lot of these, because there are people who are artists and then, they are singers or they are composers or they are songwriters or they're directors or they're actors. But to have all of those assimilate in one person and to be able to do justice like how you do it, it's amazing. It's amazing. How do you fill in so many shoes? And what has the experience been in all of these different forms? Like, as an anchor, how are you different than a singer? Or how are you different as a conceptualizer or an actor?
That's actually, I feel, a lot of people feel that, as I was telling you, my Guruji also says that, it's just one life and you have to stick to one thing, and that's the penance. That's like penance, you are just going about with that. But I personally feel that it is the sheer I feel courage in you to try it first. If one can have the courage to try that, then they will know how good or could be good or better in that. And I feel each of them, acting, anchoring, singing, composing, writing, all of them, aid the other. They will help you with the other. If you're a good singer, it will help you compose. If you're a good composer, it will help you sing well and write lyrics. If you're a good lyricist, it will help you do good anchoring. If you're all of these, then you can emote well in your acting. I feel, I feel they all are beautifully connected. It is only for the one to discover the connection. The time you discover that connection, and each of them will have their own connection. It is not the same link or the link that will link all of them. It will be something else for me, something else for you. So it is only up to us till we discover it. I think post it is like you'll be just playing with it. It is it's a kind of till you know, it's like a Brahma Vidya types. That once you know, it is like it's easy. And I feel what it helps also is to break the monotony that the other can create. Many a times what happens, I've seen my friends who have started very early in their life as singers or dancers. And by the time they are in their teens or early 20s, they would have developed this kind of fatigue and boredom with that. They would feel, I want to take a break. I'm like, why do you want to take a break? I mean, so the things that you create parallel to what you're actually doing. Like, if I want to be a singer as my, you know, main forte for my life, then if I create a few parallels, that will help me really, first of all, you know, fight this fatigue and boredom that it can create. Because this is new age, it's not something like in ancient times wherein it was only this and we would sit and pray and do. It's not like that. There are so many distractions, and unlike in the past, now success is not that easy, and one has to have a lot of patience, and there are many competitors. The competition is really high. So yeah, one cannot expect things to really happen that faster. So then one has to really have patience. In that patience, while waiting, might as well do something else, you know. So this is what actually led me do all this. That's it. I mean, but it's not an intentional thing that I started doing. I just went with the flow, you know. I got an opportunity to sing. I went to sing there. A director saw me. He called me to anchor. Another director who had come there had called me to act. So this just happened like that. Yeah,
you kept transcending yourself, I guess, right? From
That's a very, very beautiful. That's why you're an anchor, you know, because you put it so beautifully. Yes, yeah, it's very important for one to see beyond what is seen. If you can really see something beyond what is seen or shown, then that's when the new world opens to you.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. You have to have that. You know, that zeal, that energy, that positivity also to keep transcending yourself. Actually, it requires a lot. You're saying it in a very modest and a very simplistic way, but I know what it takes to keep transcending.
But I tell you, Sonal, this helps me, it helps everyone to fight the you know, the struggles of life also. This really empowers. You know, and it might be seen as something like, oh, you do multiple things, so what's the big deal? You know, it's like an old, very senior person was telling me that, Ramya, you decide what you want to do, whether you want to have a grocery store or whether you want to have a pure ghee store. I said, you know, because that was the perception, and that's how they lived. You know, yeah. He's about 90. He's about 96 now.
You can have your ghee in your grocery store also.
Yeah, so I was telling him that I used to call him, you know, Mama. So I said, Mama, the grocery stores nowadays has the best of the things sold. Nobody goes to the ghee store. So it is up to, see, the age and time and, as you said, the energy in us will all decide things for us. We should just ready to get put in that mold and then be shaped.
Also, I think what also helps is your own connection to your own self. The more you're connected to your own self, the more you will transcend, I feel, because that's when you can channelize your expressions and your emotions beautifully in so many forms, because, you know, there are less blockages then.
Yeah, and these things help you discover yourself also. Because they will tell you that how good you are. They'll tell you how bad I am. So they'll help you keep discovering oneself and keep improving.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you have anything handy in terms of your poetry, we would love to. I'm pretty sure the audience would love to hear you.
Yes. Okay, I'll sing a ghazal. I think it's one of my earliest ghazals, I think, which I wrote about 10 years back. I need Tanpura, because I feel Tanpura is very meditative, you know. It helps you be with it. So
it also gives that bass and scale, whatever.
Yeah, yeah. Ah.
लहर बन के उठी है दिल में तुम्हारी याद, लहर बन के उठी है दिल में तुम्हारी यादों हबा, दिले गुलजार तबा कर दे, दिले गुलजारे तबा कर दे, जो जी चाहे ओ मरहबा ओ मरहबा। लहर बन के उठी है दिल में तुम्हारी याद ओ मरहबा। तुझे से मिलने के इरादे हैं अगर ना पाक, तुझे से मिलने के इरादे हैं अगर ना पाक, तुझे से बिछड़ने की हमको कर दे पाक, ओ मरहबा ओ मरहबा ओ मरहबा। लहर बन के उठी है दिल तुम्हारी याद
You know what is so beautiful is each time thinking a genre, it actually takes you to that feel, that mood that you are actually in. That's the beauty of music. You know, it can take you to whatever the singer, wherever the singer take you actually. It's that powerful.
My Guruji always used to tell me one thing, that never sing for the other, you sing for yourself.
So beautiful,
उस
yeah.
गाने को अपना बनाओ कि ये अभी जो ये मैं गाना गा रही हूँ, तो दिस सॉन्ग इज माई पेन। इफ आई कैन ओनली फील माई पेन, देन आई थिंक यू कैन फील योर पेन विथ मी। अदरवाइज इफ आई ओनली ट्राई टू कीप पुटिंग अप अ शैम और अ काइंड ऑफ फसाड, इट वोंट स्टे फॉर लॉन्ग। एंड या बिकॉज इफ आई वॉन्ट यू टू टेक म्यूजिक विथ यू होम, देन आई हैव टू रियली गिव यू द ऑथेंटिक वन।
Yeah, absolutely. That is true for every aspect of life, I feel. You know, you have to be authentic to everything that you're doing. Otherwise, it's just a sham and it can't be sustained, actually. So,
Yeah.
yeah, that's the deep philosophy of life, what you just said.
In music, it is like that. You cannot have spirituality and music, do spirituality and music in life without a guru. So one has to have guru for these two things is a must. So that means that it is quite deep and it's very tough for one to keep discovering all by themselves. You need a guru for it. Yeah.
Absolutely. I would love to read all the comments that are here, but before I do that, Radha, what is one thing that binds everything together? What is that thread that actually binds everything together?
In Advaita, Shankara says so beautifully. He says that what is there inside me is inside you. So I think that's what binds all of us. It is like the oneness. The other day I was going for a walk and I saw a dog next to me, and it was trying to know me better. So it was trying to come closer to me. Then I went away a bit. It came behind me. Then I just randomly walked into somebody's house, and it was trying to see from the outside whether this house really belongs to me or not. Why am I inside? Then I just felt that, what is inside? The dog is inside me. Probably if I would have liked somebody else, I would have gone behind them. I would have seen whether this house is theirs or not. Who is she? I mean, it is just that we're all in different forms. We're all one, we're all made by that creature, that creator as one. And that's what, so I strongly, staunchly, believe Shankara is, Adi Shankara is my guru. And as he beautifully says, he says, Tattvamasi. So that is one tattva that is, and the Parabrahma is in all of us.
Yeah, absolutely.
Starting from a small worm or an insect to as dangerous as human beings.
The more,
yeah.
Absolutely. The universal consciousness is actually, that we are all a part of, basically. Absolutely. Yes. That's what binds us together. I'm going to quickly go over these. Jitendra Singh Ji, welcome.
Arriva.
And Mesul Kokila, Kumari Ramya Vashishta, the walking, talking champion of the online anchoring from North India, meets the encyclopedia of the Karnataki music hailing from the South.
That's sweet of him. I am sitting here because of him again. I should really thank him. I've been watching Sonal's chat shows. It's so beautiful and varied aspects that she brings on her chat show. So today it was all packed and done as a package was given by Jitendra sir. Yes, thank you, sir. A very happy Deepavali to you. Yeah.
Yes, a beautiful compliment. Hi Tanaz. Hi Priyanka. Hi Shalini. Jitendra bhai. Suresh ji. Ramya Vashisht, the lighted lamps on your table mark an auspicious beginning to the festival of lights. Do sing Veer Vayam, Dheer Vayam.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. That's actually that's a Sanskrita song, it's a song in Sanskrita which I composed. And I had, sung that song in World Sanskrit Conference.
Okay.
The song was basically composed for that. But then later, when there was this month, anniversary of, I think, centenarian anniversary or something, that is when I sang the song, and it was a very well received song. So that's why he's telling I should sing the song. Okay, I'll just hum this quickly for Jitendra sir. Is it okay, Sonal?
Please, please. Yeah, totally my pleasure, actually. I can sit here and listen to you for the next hour and I won't blink an eye.
I would love to sing for you. Yes, yeah, I know. We have to wind this up. Dridha manasak talala saha. Priya sahasah satatam. Ha dridha manasag talala saha. Priya sahasah satatam. Jana sevakah ati bhavukah. Shubha chintakah niyatam. Shuravayam, Dhiravayam, Veeravayam, Sutara.
गुणशालिनो बलशालिनो जयगामिनो नितराम। शूरावयं धीरावयं वीरावयं सुतरां गुणशालिनो बलशालिनो जयगामिनो नितरां।
Wow, amazing.
Oh yeah, I love this song. Yeah, thank you. Thanks for reminding this. Okay.
Yeah, that was so beautiful. Well, you know what? Like I said, I can continue listening to you for the next hour and I won't blink an eye. It is just absolutely divine. Divine is the word
Thank
for it.
you. Thank you so much.
So happy
Yes.
to have you on the show and just the right start with the festive season because, you know, we need that energy, we need that zing because of the challenging time that we are all in. Thank you, Jitendra Bhai. Thank you, Srinivas Rajuji. Thank you all, Dr. Pritesh. Thank you all for joining in always. Thank you for being such a good support. And thank you for all the lovely comments out there. Wish you all a very happy Diwali. You know, do the best to cherish these moments, you know, in spite of the challenges that we all face. Lots of positivity, abundance, and happiness and peace your way. A very happy Diwali. This is just Sonal signing off.
So much,
Thank you.
Sonal. Thanks a lot. And that was wonderful being on your show. And very happy Deepavali to all your viewers. And, maybe have a great year ahead. You know,
Yes,
I just
absolutely.
wish for a better year to come. Thank you. Happy Deepavali.
Thank you and a happy Diwali. Like, share, and subscribe, and let's build this community together. This is Jess Sonal signing off.
Thank you.